Welcome to How to Paint a Wood Elf Eternal Guard. Here's your paint list. I first base coat all the green areas using a 1-to-1 mix of Imperial Blue and Heavy Black Green. The first highlight will be just heavy black green. The second highlight is a 1-to-1 mix of heavy black green and goblin green. The next highlight will be just goblin green. And for the final airbrush highlight, we'll use a mix of ice yellow and goblin green. Now to pull all those colors together, we'll do a very nice and light coat of green ink. Now all the silver areas will be base coated using gun. and all the gold areas will be base coated using glorious gold. All the leather bits are base coated using charred brown. Heavy skin tone is used to base coat the skin. Dark flesh tone is used to highlight the leather areas. Sepia shade is applied to all the gold areas. Heavy khaki is used to base coat the wood. Ice yellow is then used to highlight the wood areas. Thank you. Now we paint the gold areas, leaving the details alone, using silver and glorious gold. The first highlight of the skin is made using a mix of elf skin tone and heavy skin tone. Then a final highlight of elf skin tone. The second highlight on the leather stuff is a one-to-one mix of dark flesh tone and bone white. Silver is then used to highlight our silver areas, a dry brush on the blades, and carefully placing it on the dragon scales or whatever you want to call them. There's another layer of cloth underneath what they wear on top, and I decided to base coat that using goblin green. Use the same color on the inside of the cloak. Goblin green helped to lighten the inside of the cloak, but we're actually going to base coat it using a 1-to-1 mix of goblin green and ice yellow. Now we use a wash of flesh tone shade on all the skin areas. Now we use silly putty to mask off areas. We're going to paint the inside of the cloak with the airbrush, so we're trying to protect all those areas that could possibly get hit. Bone white is used to highlight the inside of the cloak. I assembled the model and decided to base coat the hair with parasite brown. Actually, it's more of like a first highlight. Then highlight that with bone white. Skin wash ink is then applied over all the hair, which ties the colors together and also gives it a red hue. Taking a dab of black oil paint and mixing it with mineral spirits will give you the wash that we're applying here. I think I forgot to film this part, but once the oil wash is dry, you'll want to take clean mineral spirits and a Q-tip and clean off the excess wash off of the big flat areas. Once the oil wash was dry, I matte coated the model and then started to base coat the gems using ice yellow. Gems are then colored using scarlet red. We're about to start edge highlighting, so try to use the side of the brush rather than the tip. All the edge highlighting is done with dead white. Then I blackline the details using black and a very thin brush. I decided to airbrush sepia shade to change the look of the handle. Looked a little too plain to me. I then put a dab of black shade in the upper half of the gems. Then a dot of white at the very top of the gem. And that's pretty much it. For finishing the model, all I did was come back with gloss and paint over the gems and all the metallics. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.